The pandemic forced adult disability day programs to shut down for more than a year, leaving one of New Jersey's most vulnerable populations and their caregivers falling through the cracks.
As we're thinking about the effects of them not being able to access services like a rehabilitation and what the effect that that has on the family and the caregivers, and leading to, you know, the consumer's regression, families having to spend more money on additional services or additional support, and you know, not being able to work, it's unfortunate.
In April, daycare for intellectually and developmentally disabled adults reopened, but lack of adequate funding and reduced capacity is making it hard to keep the doors open. Jody Ann McIntosh, the director of community inclusion and dehabilitation at Easter Seals, says they had to start over reteaching learning skills with less staff.
If we had just an 8% increase in rehabilitation funding, that would make a world of difference for us being able to serve many more consumers above and beyond even what we were serving before.
Senator Holly Schapisi has been fighting for these programs and says the lack of funding and reimbursement for nonprofits during the pandemic is going to force many of them to shut down.
With people not having access to this sort of care, and what do people, as we have an aging population, do with their most vulnerable parents, grandparents, without the resources available?
While the fight for funding is ongoing, another issue is plaguing vulnerable families. Daycares for medically disabled adults suffering from issues like Alzheimer's and dementia are still closed.
We're over a year in, and there has been no guidance, no reopening, and no idea as to when these people are going to get some sort of respite for, you know, with these type of programs when everything else has opened up.
Families and advocates want to know why similar guidance cannot be issued for medically disabled adults.
I just don't understand why they couldn't use the same guidance, or if you need to make a few tweaks, do that. But I mean, it's a great baseline, if nothing else, if they can't just use it wholesale. So it's extremely frustrating.
Laura Polly travels to New Jersey from Virginia for a week every month to help care for her mother, who suffers from an atypical form of Alzheimer's that also causes severe vision impairment. With daycare still closed, she said her mom's decline has accelerated.
She's not able to do really anything for herself, dressing, feeding, bathing, all of that. Falls to my dad, who's her full-time caregiver.
She sees the toll it's taking on him too.
I can see it in his eyes and I can hear it in his voice. He's just tired. He's worn out, very frustrated from having tried to reach people in the governor's office and the commissioner's office and not getting a response, not, you know, knowing if anything's being done to work towards reopening.
Senator Schapisi says she also reached out and was told guidelines for reopening were still being created. She's concerned if daycares don't open soon, families will be forced to put loved ones in care facilities, a move Polly's family isn't ready to make.
My dad wants to keep my mom home for as long as possible.
When asked about a reopening date, the Department of Health said in a statement, quote, "The department is finalizing the guidance for these facilities and expects to release it soon." Polly and her family met with Deputy Commissioner for Public Health David Adenaro, who says he's meeting on the issue today. She was told once the draft guidance is complete, it will have to be reviewed and approved by the governor's office and offered to update them weekly, a signal to the family that it could be a while before the daycares reopen. I'm Janine Donaldson for NJ Spotlight News.